Started. Hello, hello, hello. It is Saturday and I wanted to jump on earlier today because tonight I've got other plans, as I'm sure you do as well. So let's just get into it. If you are watching on live with me right now, welcome. Come in, come in, come in. Type live so I can see who is here with me. Because the thing about Facebook Lives is that I can't always see who's jumping on and off. And if you're here with me right now on the live, type live so I can say hey. If you are here with me after watching on the replay, hit replay because I want to come and say hi to you. Also, let me know if my sound is good, if you can hear me good, if my sound is good, because, you know, sometimes my internet gives me issues, even though it's not supposed to. Let's see who is here. So if you're watching this, oh, sorry, I'm getting texts. If you are watching this on the live again, type live. On the replay, type replay. Tonight we are going to be discussing all things surrounding imposter syndrome. So we are day 11. Oh my goodness, okay. I'm getting all these texts. We are doing the Mama's 21-Day Mindset Reset, and it is all about really honing in on the new year. January is the month of hopes and dreams. We set big goals, and it's just really to keep going after them. So that's why I wanted to do the Mindset Reset, do 21 videos in about 21 days-ish, to help empower you to get after whatever it is you said you were getting after this year. So if you are working towards whatever goals, whatever your resolution is, whatever your word is, I really want you to be able to keep focusing on that and keep that front and center. Because I do think it's good to have goals. I do think it's good to work for things that you want to have in your life. And yesterday's talk was all about dieting, and it was a really cool, interesting. I had some cool feedback from afterwards, which is really, really awesome. So I like that. If I say anything that you're like curious, you want to know more about, or you want to take it on the inbox and go back and forth and have those conversations, I am totally open to that. So that's awesome. Tonight's topic, however, is all about imposter syndrome, because too often we want to do stuff and then we get scared, and we start to overanalyze stuff. We call it a paralysis of analysis. Sometimes we don't want to jump right in and do the thing. I'm not sure if I can see who is on. We don't want to jump right in and do the thing because we're scared, or maybe we start doing the thing and it's not working as we thought it would. So tonight I really want to talk about imposter syndrome, because I find that that is a mindset all of itself that doesn't serve us. And I'm going to give you some tricks on how to overcome the imposter syndrome. Not to say that if you overcome it one time, it's never going to come back again. That is not true. Actually, imposter syndrome, I'm pretty much convinced, comes from our ego. Ego likes to make us play small, stay small, live small. And I'm not talking about physically. I'm just talking about it likes to keep us in just not taking risks. You know, it wants things to be perfect. It wants you to hustle for your worthiness, all the things. So I'm not sure if I'm on properly. Here we go. So we're going to talk about imposter syndrome, and I'm going to share some personal stuff, as I always do. So let's get into it. When I first started my online coaching business, I started back in 2012. And then all of a sudden I had a bit of a rebound, and I was struggling with my own food issues and my own body image issues, that I started having like the fear of I'm not validated enough. Like who am I? Like the who am I? Who am I to think that I can coach other women online? Like, I don't look like a personal trainer. I'm not lean enough. I don't know all I don't have all the experience. I had the credentials for sure, but I, you know, it was this game that I was playing in my head. So again, like imposter syndrome, it shows up, it takes over you, and it could keep you from not moving forward. So again, I'm seeing that there's some people joining right now. Awesome. Hey, just write live so I can give you a shout out so I can see who's here. And again, if you're on the replay, that's cool too. Tonight we're going to talk about, well, tonight, what time is it? I'm saying tonight because it's almost 5. We're going to talk about imposter syndrome. We're going to talk about how sometimes we think we're not qualified enough. We don't have enough certifications. We don't have enough of the expertise. We don't know enough of the thing that we want to do. So we don't do it. So an experience for me was when I did start my online coaching, I was afraid. I thought, you know, I don't look like the other personal trainers. I don't have a six-pack abs that I walk around with all the time. And then I had my adaptation, my metabolic adaptation, and I thought, man, I'm really not qualified for this stuff. So it really played with my head, but I'm going to give you tricks that I hope you have a pen and paper right now to write down and start doing right now, because 2018 is going to be your year to actually step out full force, take your power back. Because I honestly believe that imposter syndrome, first of all, everybody gets it. And yes, these tricks that I'm going to show you, they might help. And you might have to modify, of course, do what feels good to you. But it's not to say that imposter syndrome won't come back in your life. Because right now I'm working on a really huge project for February and my ego is talking again. My ego is telling me it's not going to be good enough. Who do you think you are? You're not qualified enough. Who do you think you are? So it's just that self-talk on a loop, and I have to tell myself to stop, take a breath, and I'm just going to do it anyways. So let's get into it. Who here has ever felt that they wanted to do something and maybe you started doing the thing and maybe things got a little bit more difficult than you thought, or it wasn't exactly the way you thought it would be, so you got scared and you stopped? And if you felt like that, give me a show of hands. If you're brave enough to share on the comments, go for it. Or you wanted to do the thing, you overthought it, like you overanalyzed and you did all the research and you pretty much knew it inside and out, but you were too afraid to take the steps because in your mind you were telling yourself, I can't do that. I can't do that. So I want to know who here has felt like that. Give me a show of hands. I felt like that. I have started things and wanted to stop or stopped doing the things because I wasn't qualified enough. And I think that the little puppy wants to go outside. Oh, she's going downstairs. So here we go. Here are some tips. Number one, I want you to practice practical pessimism. What that is, and I'm trying to remember whose concept that's from. I'm sorry. I know. If you Google practical pessimism, you will find out whose theory this is. But practical pessimism pretty much is just what it sounds like. You are going to take the negative thoughts that you're having and ride it out. So you're going to ask yourself, well, I want to do this thing, but what's the worst thing that can happen? And ride it out. Or say it out loud or think it in your head. And then ask yourself, well, what's so bad about that? And write it out. And just keep going into that thought process, questioning, getting deep, and keep asking yourself, like, what's so bad about that? Could I handle that? It probably wouldn't be comfortable, no, but could you figure it out? And you'll probably come to the conclusion that, yeah, you could most certainly figure it out. Of course, it probably wouldn't be comfortable, but then again, growth doesn't come from comfort. So if you do end up having to experience what your worst case scenario is, you probably could figure it out. And you would get some really good life skill lessons from it and move on. So obviously, we don't like living in the discomfort. It's not fun. But we could figure it out. Like, you know, if we were put in that kind of a situation, guaranteed we could figure it out. So I want you to ask yourself, write it down. I'm a big fan of like writing out the questions and writing down the answers. There's just a process in the writing that I really like, but you do what's good for you. Next, I really like the 3 R's by Brandon Burchard. Basically, it's to come to, and this, and why I'm going to share this is because I have a lot of women who ask me, or friends who ask me, like, how do you get to be an online coach? How do you get to do this? What kind of credentials do you need? Who said you were an empowerment coach? First of all, I gave myself that title, okay? Like, I just took it. Yes, I have the certifications. I have maybe a little bit too much, okay? The reason I did that is because my ego told me I didn't have enough. So what I want you to know is, yes, be qualified, get a certification. You don't have to have all the certifications. You don't have to go like into massive debt like I did to get all these certifications. Get the ones that you need and then build the expertise from the experience you're going to get from practicing the thing you want to do. So Brandon Burchard has three R's, his three R's of expertise. First one is the role model. So these are the people who are like walking the walk, talking the talk. They are living it. So there's the role model. His second R are the people who are the results getters. So those are the people who are actually, they do the thing, they teach the thing, they get the results for whatever the thing is that they're doing, right? And the third R is the researcher. So those are the people in the background doing all the research, figuring out what works, what doesn't. So the way I like to look at his 3R model is I honestly think that we are like a culmination of all three. We're all teachers, we're all students. We all have our own stories. We all have our own levels of expertise. And when it comes to our own stories, oftentimes we just diminish our own stories because we don't think that there's enough value in sharing those stories. We'll just like play it off like, oh yeah, you know, I did this thing, but it's really not a big deal. You know, like, oh yeah, you know, I lost 100 pounds, but it's not a big deal. Or, oh yeah, you know, I started my own online business, but it's not a big deal. You have to understand that the thing that you're doing is awesome. The thing that you've lived through is awesome. And it could bring great value to another human being. I find that we play small so much when it comes to sharing our own stories and parts of ourselves that could help another human being. And here is where I find it's really sad. I find it's a huge disservice. Because if we were more honest in sharing those parts of ourselves with people who obviously we are willing to share with, the world would be a better place because we can all learn from each other. We can all grow from each other. We're all teachers and students. So what I'm saying is don't diminish your stories. Like if somebody thinks that you have something to teach them, I always say this. All you need to do is be a little bit more qualified in the thing that you want to do than the people who want to learn it. That's all. You don't need to be 10 steps ahead. You just need to be a few steps ahead, and then you teach the thing that you learned to them, and then it's a benefit. It's beneficial for the whole collective. It's beneficial for all of us because we're all learning from each other. So, if you are wanting to do something this year and you're afraid to do the thing because you think you're not qualified enough, I'm going to tell you yes. Get the credentials you need, and then start doing the thing. Because nobody's going to tell you that you're qualified enough. Nobody. If you have the credentials you need, the knowledge you have, go get that expertise by the practice of doing the thing in and of itself. So you can do whatever you want. Just do it. If you want to start writing, just write. I mean, I write all the time. Am I a writer? No. But one day I'm going to write a book. Like I've already wrote an ebook, but one day I'm going to write a legit book. Like I have this goal of mine that my husband and I are going to write a marriage book. Like we are going to write a book. I'm not necessarily a writer, but I'm not stopping myself I'm not stopping myself there because I can get better. I can get better. So I don't stop myself when I'm writing a blog or I'm writing a newsletter. Sure, proofread, sure, my grammatical sentence structures probably are not the best, but that doesn't paralyze me. I press publish, go, because that is what is going to help me. I don't sit there and get caught up in the color schemes and all the, those are minute details. Like, I find people, I've had a few women ask me, how do you start a blog? Listen, don't get caught up on the big picture stuff. Start on the little stuff because it's actually the little stuff that is the big picture stuff. So I'm talking about, don't worry about your color scheme of your background. Don't worry about this. Don't worry about that. Just get the content out. Write the content. Show up. Everything else is not as important as you think it is. And people might point it out, okay? I get people who point out all the time when I have errors, and I don't take that personal. I just think like, okay, fine, I'm doing the thing, that's fine. It's a benefit for everybody involved, but I don't get caught up in that. Whereas before, I might have just shut down and been like, well, I'm not a writer, so I'm just gonna give up. You know what I mean? I want you to just think, like, what is it that you want to do? And if that imposter syndrome is kicking in, that's your ego talking, and you need to tell it to sit down. Like, get it busy doing other things. The next thing, the last thing actually, so the first thing is you're going to you're going to practice the practical pessimism. You're going to ask yourself, what's the worst case scenario, and write it out. And then ask yourself, will you be okay figuring it out? Guaranteed you will. The second thing you're going to do is you're going to actually think about what it is you have to offer. So what do you have to offer? And like I said, Brandon Burchard, he's got those three R's, you know, he's got the role model, the results getter, and the researcher. And this is applicable for anything, okay? Ask yourself, what stories, what things of value do you have to add, and don't diminish them, because you have incredible gifts. I believe everybody is on this earth for a reason, okay? It's not just random. We're all here because we all have unique gifts and talents, and we're supposed to share them. So look and see, what can you offer? And then start doing the thing. Don't get scared. So number three is just do it. Just do it, because that is how you're gonna gain your confidence and your competence to keep going and to take bigger risks and to jump further and not get stuck on the small stuff like punctuation and color background schemes and grammatical sentence structures, like not getting stuck on the minute details, because the grander scheme of things is that you're doing the thing. You're doing it when a lot of other people are stuck in the backgrounds because they're afraid of what everybody else is thinking. So you just do it. So if you suffer, or if you've ever suffered from imposter syndrome, and you've ever had yourself questioning yourself, like, what do you think you are? You don't have enough credentials. You're not good enough for this. All that stuff. I'm going to tell you, we need you. I need you. I need you to step up. Fully, in your full being, I need you to step up, I need you to show up, and I need you to just, like, teach me. Let's do this. Because you have to evolve, right? It's about evolving, and that is what I find is so beautiful. You have so much great potential. Don't let other people tell you to stay small, especially your ego. Don't live small. Live big. Take up all the space in your body to take up all the space in your world and see how everything changes. And yeah, some people are going to talk. But again, go back a few videos where I told you, like, it doesn't matter because you're doing the thing. So just do it. And when it comes to that constructive criticism, here's the last thing I'll end with. Constructive criticism is good. Why? Because we're all so busy. We're all so busy scrolling. So if somebody takes time out of their busy schedule to point out something to you, I mean, you can at least listen, and then you get to decide if it's valid for you or not, and be gracious about it and let it go. But if somebody is honestly reaching out to you as a way for constructive criticism, that's cool. They took the time out of their busy day. You know, if somebody's writing you a long, long paragraph, like, that takes time, especially on, like, our little phones. Okay? Read it. Take what you want with a grain of salt. Be kind about it. Like, don't be a jerk. and then decide what you want. I'm loving all these hearts. Awesome. So, yeah, basically what I want you to do. So, who here in 2018 is going to step up, whatever that means to you, and do something, okay? And again, it doesn't have to be these big things, you know? Sometimes it's like the littlest things, but it's that little thing inside you that you've been wanting to get after forever. You go do that thing. You go take up that space, because that is yours. That's your intuition talking. That's your intuition telling you, those are your gifts. This is what you need to do. So start doing it. Start shining from the inside out, and it's gonna impact all of us. So basically, that is all I got to do. I want you to go do the thing. Go learn from it. Sure, you might suck at it, but guess what? Nobody is born doing all the things perfectly. We're not. You learned how to walk, you can learn how to do anything. Because babies fall like over 70,000 times before they take one step. So thank goodness we didn't say, walking's not cut out for me, right? I guess I'm not cut out for walking. No, we just kept getting up and going and going and going. And surround yourself with like-minded people who are gonna push you, who are gonna push you further, so that when you get those constructive criticism remarks or whatever, you can use them as a sounding board to be like, is this true for you or not? And move from it, grow from it, evolve from it, because 2018 is going to be magnificent. I already feel it. I'm already feeling sassy, you know, and I want this for you. I want you to hone in on that, because it is going to be your year, Brenda. So that is all I got. Tomorrow we're going to talk about another hot topic, all about what other people's opinions are and how you can flip it. And if you have questions, I'm thinking sometime, maybe next weekend, I'll do a Q&A. So you can ask me anything. I'm going to open it up to finances. I'm going to open it up to pretty much anything. So you can ask me any questions, stick it, maybe send it in my inbox. Or maybe I'll create a thread as well on my Facebook. I'll create a thread. You can throw the questions in there. And if you're too shy to ask the question with everybody else knowing it's you, send it in my inbox. And I will pick a date next week to do one of the mindset resets. We'll all be about Q&A. So I'm going to pick some of those questions. And I'm there for you. So that's all I got. And I got to go and finish supper because, you know, chores. So thanks for being here. Peace, love. Get it.